Hey everyone, I'll be doing a commentary on The Last Revolution against BDK. So this is the Finnish team, usually known as Finnish Hitters, against the French team, usually known as Kut, I believe. The German team. Alrighty, so this is Uncharted R, so this would have been round 2 of the AT. We've got The Last Revolution with... Okay, they're running their sort of normal Warrior Paragon 2 Mez Ellie build. So I've talked about that build before, I consider it kind of a counter build. If you don't have anything to camp with the Wastrels, and especially if your Lightning Surge can be shut down, it can be pretty difficult to win. But it's very good against Ellie builds. Because you can on the split with your Lightning Surge, which probably has Spirit Bond. I've never seen, I don't think I've seen LR not run Spirit Bond on this Ellie. And you've got the Wastrels counter to the Ellies. Okay, I'll just call them Kaput, I think. Or I don't know, we'll see how I go. Kaput running 2 frontline, double ranger Necro. So I think that this pretty heavily favors Kaput. The one thing in LR's favor is they've got a Flesh Paragon. Well, I'm sure it'll be a Flesh Paragon against double ranger Necro, but I think that double ranger Necro still is. Very strong composition against this. There's really nothing to camp with the Wastrels. It's pretty hard for the Lightning Surge to do much damage. Like, mid line is Rangers and a Necro that'll be running Flag, so there's not really much that he can really do all that much damage to unless he just trains out front line, which I'm sure he'll probably do. So Whirling defends on the Ranger. Usually when you see Ranger Warrior, it means he's the Nettis, but it's got Whirling, which is interesting to note. Point blank as well, so it's probably got... because this is a Burning Arrow with point blank, that probably means he doesn't have Snare. Ooh, nearly going down there actually. Very low. Looks like Kaput might have just been running on their flagger for a second. Alright, LR bringing in their flag on their Ellie, the Lightning Surge, while Kaput running on the Necro. So even though there's Flesh Paragon, a lot of this poison is still going to be getting up. And poison, it's not completely negated by the fact that there's a Flesh Paragon. Flesh Paragon is kind of a little bit overrated, I think, against poison, just because even if you use Flesh, you still don't get any healing, so you still take the pressure. Another thing to note is that LR is running a Monk Ellie on the number 8, so this is... I'm not a big fan of this. Just because you kind of need your attributes a lot on Monk Flagger, I feel. Except when you run a Monk Ellie, which means that you're probably going to have Snare and the Water Speed Boost. It means you have to spread your attributes a lot more. So we see the 26 from the Guardian right there, which means like... I think... 8 in Divine Favor, which is really not... Not that much. D-shot on the Lightning Surge there, so this push is going to be really strong with the Lightning Surge D-shot. Gonna need the... Oop, I guess not that strong actually. Unless I can get the RC out right here. No, RC gets off, and he's gonna get right through. So, looks like LR have a slight flag advantage. Just Necro up them to go for Footman rather than run Flag straight off. Getting countered by the Wastrels of LR, but the Wastrels. Okay, so Gorbia actually has Aether Fist, which is interesting. He's got Aether Fist and Dash, so that means that he's either got one Wastrels or two Rups, unless he's not running Drain. So I'll be very interested to see what Bardgodly has. He's only using Demise right now, so he might not have Wastrels Worry actually. Actually, killing going down there, probably partly due to the snare there, so the Monk Ellie actually paying off early in the game. There's Lightning Surge on the front line. The Sinker's sitting pretty far back to do that. So, okay, Kaput is actually now ahead on a full flag. This push is being really effective for them. It's really hard for them to deal with it. They need the Paragon to be removing the cripples. Yeah, these cripples are really hurting them. The longer they take to get this flag, the worse it is for them. And the much better it is for Kaput, because they're not going to be under any pressure while they're pushing this flag. Now they'll be under a little bit of pressure, but LR have to run right away. And this is a... You can see how much pressure they're under right now. It's going to be pretty hard for them to run under this pressure. They're going to be running on sync as well, so they'll have even less to push back Kaput. This is really a very dangerous situation for LR to be in. Also, another thing about the Monk Flagger is I think that probably means he won't have Shield Guardian. So against double rangers, Shield Guardian, especially with Nemez, Shield Guardian is really, really, really strong. You definitely want it. But I think that LR will probably only have one Shield Guardian because they'll have the snare rather than the Shield Guardian Monk Flagger. So yeah. One footman still up. Can't see what the other one is, must have been taken out. Oh, no, there it is. So yeah, Kaput could just push into the footman right there without even really caring. Just shows how little pressure they're under. And BDK is double running flags. Sorry, I'm using BDK and Kaput a little bit interchangeably. I apologize to the people in BDK if they don't feel represented as Kaput players. So this is really not good for LR. They can't win the flag game. It doesn't look like they're getting... Well, they almost got a kill there. They can... They really need to... I don't know. It seems like they can really only score kills on the Dervish, I think. I mean, they got this Ranger load before, but... They kind of need the Shatter damage, I think. Because they're running double Mez. So the only guy that can really get the Shatters on is the Dervish. So unless they can kill the Dervish, it might be very difficult for them. But it should be pretty obvious every time they're spiking. With only the Axe Warrior frontline. It's not very fast, and it's usually pretty telegraphed when he's going to attack. Okay, so Body Blow and Dismember and Eviscerate. So that's a triple dupe wound. So that'll help him fake out a little bit and be a little bit less predictable with the three deep wounds that LR is having to pull back right now. A little bit, I think. Ply gets taken out though by the Complicate from Ra, I think. Godly bringing this flag in. He's gonna get crippled straight away. LR under a lot of pressure right now. They really need to flesh wound the cripple on the flagger. On Godly, I mean. Because he's gonna get pushed really hard right here. Oh no, this is looking very risky. So LR are just gonna have... You're gonna be pretty open to the push right here, I think. If Kaput go for it. With the three monks pushing up. But nope, Kaput will follow them. Sorry, Sync is splitting, I missed that. Sync is pulling off the split right now, will be defended by the monk flagger of BDK. This is... I'm not sure if I'm a fan of this because... If Sync splitting, it really means that LR have no way at all to push back BDK main team. I mean, BDK can just defend this with a flagger, and their main team composition is just way, way, way better. The 4 damage, usually when you're solo splitting and holding back a flagger, it's a pretty good composition for your main team, except with BDK's build, they have nothing to camp with the Wastrels. They don't really have a very good way of getting flags and, like, not that effective at running flags through. They don't have a ranger or something that can actually block attacks when he's running. And so... It really feels like, unless they can score it. So there's the two shatters, and he still didn't die. That's about as clean a spike as they're gonna get, and they couldn't score a kill on it, so... I think that LR is gonna need to change things up if they wanna pull ahead. BDK still ahead on flags. Feels like LR is... kind of waiting to take deaths in this trade-off. They'd be better off maybe if they split off the Wastrels, because the Wastrels can't camp anything in main team. Then the Lightning Surge would be able to do a lot of damage, and the 4 damage composition in main team by splitting off the Wastrels and having LS at main might actually allow them... Well, it would be much better than this composition right here. Especially with only one Wastrels on Godly. Which I'm pretty sure he only has one. Nearly gone down there, nice Aegis by Ali. So I think he was going for a little bit of lore damage there. So if he times his skills right as a lightning surge, you'll be able to get a few ticks of 30 damage. There's one through the entourage. Lightning surge is pretty good at this, especially on this map. If you can start getting lore damage early, it can really build up over time. But yeah, Paragon does go down for LR, and that is gonna make things really hard for them. I think they're definitely gonna change things up now if they survive. So they're not gonna get this flag through, not with the Paragon dead at least. And with their backline, this taking this much pressure. Okay, they dropped the flag, probably not gonna try and get it out. BDK running another flag on the Necro. And BDK is just gonna play it safe, looks like. Just wait for the boost. Maybe it could actually collapse in the middle right here and pretty much guarantee a kill on Sync. Sync probably knows it, so he's might start pulling out. Knows in a bit of risky position. Nope, he actually pushes back in, so this is especially with Spirit Bond, which you know, I'm pretty sure he has. I don't think I've seen it, but I've never seen him run patient. With Spirit Bond, the Necro can do a lot of damage to him on a collapse. So if the Necro was to run through middle right now, he could probably kill Sync. Even the Ranger, the Melantra Shot Ranger, can also collapse and probably score a kill on him. But it looks like BDK is just happy with leaving him in the back, but Godly is now splitting off as well. So, one advantage for LR is Godly's bar, with only one Wastrels and the Aether Feast instead. It does mean that he's a little bit more sustainable on split side, or actually quite a lot more sustainable, but can't kill NPCs as fast because won't have Wastrels worry, but the two heals and the dash will make him very strong, very durable. The Sync is dead here, there's no way he's getting out of this. Almost no way. A monk actually coming in. Wow, he might actually survive this. It looks like Sync might have gotten the L Surge off. Not removed. I didn't catch that, sorry, but that was a nice play by LR to survive that. That was a very dangerous spot to be in. They're going to take this fight though, and this is as good a fight as they're probably going to get. Actually getting... Ooh, okay. So yeah, they are doing quite well on this 3v3 here. Oh, but Sync goes down. That is rough. They were very close to scoring a kill there and base resing the monk flagger, which would have let them score kills probably on at least Dervish, if not both the Dervish and the Necro. So the monk flagger for LR will go down here. But that's really great for them that they did nearly score a kill on the flagger there. I mean, that shows that they have potential in this split, if they can get a split going. Might be a little bit hard for them now. They probably need to sneak a res out, considering that was right after time, at death. And considering Godly might go down. Yeah, he's going down. Probably would need to see a res come out the back here. BDK would do well to just keep pushing this, to be honest, and connect their main team. But just gonna play safe, it looks like. Get the footman and looks like they want to pull back. It's a safe way to play, but they probably could have pushed in if they wanted, but can't blame them for not wanting to run into a full pit. So we're probably going to see out of LR when they're base res, we're going to see probably a bigger split, and so it's actually interesting that they defend with the Dervish. Usually teams with Ranger Necromez, oh sorry, Dual Ranger I guess, usually teams opt to defend splits with the Nashot Ranger, but they opt to defend it with the Dervish and keep the two Rangers main team. It worked out pretty well for them, but as we saw before, it was a little bit risky. They didn't really have much defense against a Lightning Surge. Like with the Necro and the Dervish, they have no way to stop it from casting, so it can get off all its damage. If they have a Ranger, at least they can rupt a couple of its skills. It just means that it takes a little bit longer for them to kill against LR Split. So if they defend the same way, it might give LR a little bit of a chance to win the 3v3. If they defend with the Mail Shot, it might be a little bit harder for LR. So BDK going for an 8v8 right here. They're probably gonna... I gotta think that they'll disengage from this soon though. This is not a winning battle to be fighting. Actually getting the Dervish quite low again, but it's really the only guy that they can spike, it feels. Aggressive looked like he might have been rupted there. Yeah, Paragon attacking without aggressive right here. BDK under no pressure at all. And LR under quite a lot of pressure. This is interesting that LR is choosing to still try and hold this fight. Looks like they're pulling back a little bit. Maybe we want to get the knights in at least or something. Seem really motivated to try and win this AP8, but such a difficult AP8 for them to win. Even if they score kills, BDK can just res up straight away and then they'll be stuck in the same situation as before. Unless LR can score some really nice time kills or something. Yeah, they're going for the split again. Breaking the 8v8, but it's going to cost them the knights waiting so long to split. Because they split when they were under a lot of pressure, it let BDK push even harder and get those knights down. Or at least get one of the knights down, I think. This link will be splitting against the Monk Flagger again. BDK just... Okay, Sync is actually fake. He's faking, so he's running through middle. He might go for a collapse right here. It's kind of hard to make this work though, because it's so easy for the Monk Flagger to just see he's not back and then he can sit like right around this spot here and pretty much see exactly what Sync is doing, unless he sits around back here. But if you sit around that spot right there where I'm putting the mouse, you can see if he's going in your back door or if he's cutting through the middle, so it makes it quite hard to pull off some sneaky moves against good Monk Flaggers. They've got this splitting off as well. I'm going to see a collapse through the middle, so this is probably going to mean that LR just pull off the split side. So defending with the Dervish again. Worked well for them last time, so why not do it again? Not sure how strong the main team composition is though when they do this, when they defend with the Dervish. I would have thought that having two frontline main would be a lot stronger than just the one frontline, especially the one Axe Warrior. Bullstrike gets diverted right there, but he's going to be back in just 20 seconds. I guess as long as LRS and their Monk Flagger to split, the two Ranger and one frontline composition of main team is still pretty strong. Hemo is not gonna... Well, this is kind of difficult flag to get in. Looks like he's gonna make it though, but it's gonna open up their front door. This is a great job by Kaput. Noticing that they can push front door when LR try and get the flag in. Yep, there's a nice knight kill by Fate. So there's one monk here right now, or two monks rather, because the flag is here. One monk up with Hemo. It'll just be Ali, but okay, they're gonna be fine. So LR did get that flag in, but they didn't really get anything from it. Kaput took advantage of it by getting knight down. And death there on the heal monk of Kaput. I think they'll be fine though. I think that was just a little bit of a misplay by the backline of Kaput. Thing to notice there is a Sig Reju on the Heal Monk, that slot is usually between either Sigriju, Shield Guardian, Spotless, or something else like that. It's like the spare slot on a Monk Flagger. So, LR really haven't been running Ranger Necromancers for quite a long time like they used to a lot. So teams are starting to sort of bring less Shield Guardians against them. Which is just something interesting to note. Sigriju is a lot stronger against this composition, I think, than a Shield Guardian would be on the Flagger. Another option you can run is Shield of Absorption. It's quite nice against double Mez teams, just because it gives you like an extra enchantment that doesn't sort of that stacks well with Shielding Hands. If you bring Shielding Hands on the Flagger and you bring another Prop Monk, then if one of them gets stripped, then they can both get stripped, which is really not optimal sometimes. That's why we see a lot of Shield of Absorption these days in Flagger Monks. Also Prot Spirit for the same reason with Spirit Bond. Lets you deal with double Mesmins a little bit better. So, Mesmer and Ellie and Monk split from LR. Being defended with Dervish again. It'll be interesting to see what LR does in this situation with their split, because they need to make a play on split side. The only way that they can win this is if they get something done on split side, because their main team, their composition is just so much weaker than Kaput's. They're not going for risky plays though, it looks like. They're just sort of pulling back to their base a little bit. They probably need to pull something risky out. The Necro for Kaput going back to main team. See Sync and Godly wanting to resplit. Kaput defending with Dervish and Monk. Looks like the white Necro might be just waiting to sort of collapse as soon as LR commit on the split. But LR really need to make something happen here. Especially a lore damage, it's really going to be in favor of. But it's going to be really, really difficult for LR to get lore damage and really stop the lore damage of Kaput. But yeah, we see the Necro now sort of collapsing on the splits. This is as good a fight as any for LR to take there. Yeah, they're going to snare the Necro over there. This is going to be a nice for them to wait for this opportunity. It's a great opportunity. Even if the Necro dies now though, it's just gonna base res. Okay, it doesn't die, but this is gonna be a nice, very, very good spot for Kaput to fight in, because it leaves this Monk Flagger open to all the rups from Godly. You can't sort of stay at range. This is gonna be a really close battle. Looks like LR is losing it though quite a lot. The Necro and Dervish combination just too strong. Not able to sort of get up the pressure and the rups that they need. Yeah, this is where Spirit Bond really hurts as a Heli splitter, a Lightning Surge. If he had Breeze or Mystic or Patient, anything else basically, this would be a lot easier to fight into. So LR is gonna just pull back, try and collapse the main team probably. Actually, it looks like they might be. Okay, this is the risky play I was talking about before that they have to make. They have to send like a bunch of guys to split side and try and make something drastic happen. Then the Warrior and the Paragon right now. You're gonna see probably Proc go back for Kaput. This is gonna leave one Monk at main team, but they're gonna be pushing one Monk into the pit against one Mez. And no, LR is just gonna collapse and push BDK out of the base. Dish on the Lightning Surge there, it's gonna slow down all the damage. Not gonna be able to catch anything now, because Lightning Surge is, other than the Monk Flagger, Lightning Surge is really the only movement control. And there's the Rough on the Ice Prison. Killian doing a great job for his team there, shutting down the movement control. So we're probably gonna see a split happen right away from LR, I'm guessing. Yeah, it looks like Hemo wants to split off. nice to see him splitting off. They really need to change things up like this, because what they've been doing just hasn't been working, so... And it's getting so close to 28 that they just need to do something different. Monk flag going back. As I was saying before, it might be good if they just tried to solo split Godly. If he could hold back a Monk flagger, I mean, it doesn't feel like he can do really anything in main team, especially with Aetherfist. He's running sort of more of a split bar and less of a useful APA bar. So Paragon, okay, it's been with the Paragon now. This is actually going to be pretty cool. This is a nice move of them. It's going to deal with the Necro, Degen a lot, and the Dervish. This is actually a great idea. The only problem is that the Paragon can just get trained out. So I think if they split with the Paragon and the Lightning Surge, or I don't know actually. But swinging at the Paragon is a nice idea. This is going to nullify quite a lot of the Necro. Especially if this Monk has Mending Touch and can just Mending Touch the Paragon. Because all the Necro's conditions, he's probably just going to put them on the Paragon because he can't remove his own. So, Caput is now defending with the Ranger. So this is the Nullshot Ranger rather than the Dervish. But even though they split the Paragon, which I've said is nice, they're really not going to be able to do anything from this position. They've got no way to take out NPCs with this composition. Paragon really has pretty low DPS, there's no way you can get the archers down, and Hemo can't push in. But they have got Ra coming to the split side, so it looks like they're splitting with their main team now, which means that they probably want this to be their low damage composition. So it's a nice move. You probably want to go for low damage rather than bodyguard, I think. So Aim on Targaryen having a bit of a hard time here, pushing in against the 2 damage. So yeah, this is the Lord Defense team of BDK and the Lord Offense team of LR right here. This is what they want to use at 28. So it's a nice job by both teams setting up. Usually with like Ranger Necro Mesmer builds, I would build with the Ranger and the Necro. Defending with the Ranger, the Melshot, and the Necro is just extremely effective. It's one of the best defenses you can get at 28. It's one of the best base defenses in general. It's just so strong. You got the strips and a lot of degen spread, and LR is gonna not survive for long with all these NPCs pulled. They're actually going for the kill, it looks like, kind of. Yeah, that Lord damage team is going to die very quickly. Meanwhile, Caput is getting a lot of their own Lord damage with 2 frontline. You can see the 2 monks of Caput, sorry, 2 monks of LR are in their own base. Pro Monk is now going back for Caput, where Godly is split on LR side. That's going to be 4 damage in Caput's base. Kill Monk does basically get soloed by Sync here. It's quite difficult to sometimes to play into these NPCs with a Lightning Surge on your ass as a Kill Monk without any prots. So Aemon Targaryen does go down. Nice rubbed on the res there. Hemo goes down so he can't res either. It's interesting that LR actually have a lot of Stigs left, it seems. At least 2 Stigs left. Which is pretty rare at this point in the game where you've been on the back foot. So I think this game is going to go to Caput, or BDK rather. So congratulations to BDK. But they had a pretty significant build advantage. And thank you for watching, and see you next time.